And my essay is called Writings on the Wall, and it is about my struggles with faith and identity, and kind of tracks my post-high school relationship with faith. Right after 9/11 happened is when I entered college, and then I did a lot of soul searching when I moved to New York for grad school. And the metaphor that is very strong in this essay is that of the return. And as Muslims, we know that we talk a lot about the return to Allah, the return back home safely. And I took this concept of the return back home safely that, you know, we always said in my family and frequently spoke about from a verse from the Quran, from Surah Al-Qasas. And that verse goes, "Verily, he who ordained the Quran for you will bring you back to the place of return. Say, my Lord knows best who it is that brings true guidance and who is in manifest error." We used to take this verse from the Quran and we used to write it up on our wall before we would travel to ensure a safe return. And at a certain point, I refused to do it. Not that it was an Islamic imperative, but we just, it was something cultural that we picked up from generations. And I refused to do it to assert my identity as somebody who didn't practice Islam at that moment. And then as the essay goes on, it shows how I come back. And so this is a paragraph from my chapter. It starts out with an ayah from Surah Al-Fajr. "O soul made peaceful, return to your Lord, accepted and accepting." Surah Al-Fajr 89:27-28. As I retell the story of my relationship to Islam, I feel strange speaking of going back. This somehow misrepresents the nature of my journey with faith. How can I go back if I never truly left? In retrospect, my bouts with questioning God's existence were part of my understanding of faith. My faith was strengthened by the depths of doubt and disbelief excavated from the world's soil, where I discovered hidden treasures that love to be known. As Ibn Arabi says, God is not just being or existence, but something that must be found.